Hello, my name is Aldo Vasquez, and welcome to a special Make It Monday. All month long, we will be leading up to our super fun event, Steam Powered Saturday, which takes place virtually on May 8th. We'll have special musical guests and other fun surprises that day. And then from May 8th to May 15th, we will have a special Steam Week where we'll have different programs and events taking place. But today, I'm going to focus on the T part of Steam, which is technology. More specifically, I'll be talking about coding. So coding is a method of giving a computer instructions to perform a specific task. You may also hear coding referred to as software programming or computer programming. These are just instructions that are communicated using a special language that computers can understand. So where is coding found? Well, coding is found all around us in all of our technology. Almost all technology runs through a code, like these robots here, for instance. And they are controlled by commands that you send to the robot. So for example, if I were to take my little friend here, turn him on, press this button here to tell him to go forward twice, and then press this button, the robot is gonna move forward. So I just inputted a simple command that the robot followed and sent him on his path. These special robots here, will be controlled by any code that you input into a program, and then it sends it to the robot to tell it to either draw or do special commands or even climb a wall like this magnetic robot here. Now, there are a lot of great programs online that can teach you how to code, but today I'm going to show you how to play a fun game with a friend offline using code. So robots can only do what they're told to do. But we don't just tell them using words. In order to do something, a robot needs to have a list of steps that it can read. So today we're going to learn what it takes to make that happen. For example, using a set of symbols in place of code, you can design an algorithm to instruct the robot to stack cups in a different pattern, similar to this here. Now, while you're doing this at home, you should take turns with your friend participating as a robot and as the person who's giving the commands. Just make sure that you only respond to the algorithm defined by their directions. It's a lot more fun that way if you are simply following simple commands rather than going off script. Well, let's get started. So for today's activity, all you're going to need are some cups, a piece of paper or scrap paper to write down your commands. I've already written down a few commands here. Some scissors if you want to cut your paper into smaller pieces of paper for the commands, and a marker. So for this task, I'm going to be instructing my buddy John. He's going to be the robot, and he's going to try to recreate this stack of cups here. You might want to print out the key so that your robot can see it first so they can understand what commands or what the symbols mean. Also, just make sure that your robot understands each key. For here, I wrote down, for example, this down arrow command means put the cup down. You can start out by putting the command right on the piece of paper, or if you want to make it harder, have the robot look at the commands first and then just go for the symbols afterwards. Okay, so I'm going to ring in my robot. Let's see if we can get him to recreate this stack.
Hi everyone, I'm Mr. John. Today I will be playing the role of the robot. I'll be listening to all of the commands that Mr. Aldo gives me.
So today the commands that we're using are up, which looks like this. And up just means that the cup automatically goes up as high as it needs to. We'll also be using down, which just means that the cup automatically goes down until it lands on something. Then we have the step forward command, which just means to step forward. This one here, step back. These are just about like one step. And lastly, we have our left and right commands. So this just means to move one step left or one step right. And now we will begin. Thank you. so we have completed our stack by using the list of steps that I gave to my robot, and that's called an algorithm. Algorithms are great for sharing ideas, but spelling them out word by word can take a long time. So that's what the symbols are for. When you change an algorithm into symbols that a robot or computer understands, that's called programming. Another fun way you can play this game is by running a really long code and seeing if you have created a correct pattern for your robot. Instead of just doing individual directions, you can write down a number of symbols and codes, show it to your robot, and see if they can run the correct pattern. Another even more fun way that you can play this game at home, especially during the summer, is by grabbing some sidewalk chalk, creating a maze, and then having your robot friend try to get through the maze by using simple directions. Well, thanks everyone for joining me today. Don't forget to check out our website at shypublib.org for more fun programs and events. And be sure to tune in on May 8th for our kickoff celebration to STEAM Week. Bye everyone, take care, and have a good one. Be sure when you're doing this activity to also include a step where your robot has to do a robot dance.